by the Laplace transform of e to the t cos I t. By the definition, the Laplace transform of f of t is equal to the integral from 0 to infinity e to the negative st f of t dt. So whatever f of t is, you just plug it into here. Then I have the integral from 0 to infinity e to the negative st e to the t cos I t dt. Now I'm going to combine these two, so add the exponent together, which gives me e to the negative st plus t times cos I t dt. We have an improper integral, so we have to take a limit as w goes to infinity integral from 0 to w. It doesn't matter which letter, what letter you use here, as long as it's different from t. For this one, I'm going to factor out t. So in parentheses, I have... I'm going to factor out negative t. So in parentheses, I have s minus 1 times t. So distribute this, I have negative st minus minus plus t, okay? Times cosine t dt. So to integrate this, we are going to integrate it by part. Let u equal e to the negative s minus 1t. Then du equals negative s minus 1 e to the negative s minus 1 times t. dv equals cosine t dt. Then v equals sine t. Then this becomes the limit as w goes to infinity integral from 0 to w. This becomes e to the negative of s minus 1t psi t plus integral from 0 to w s minus 1 e to the negative s minus 1t psi t. Forgot dt here. Dt. So again, we still have the integral, so we are going to take the integral of this again. And we are going to use integration by part method again. Let u equal s minus 1 e to the negative s minus 1 times t. Then du equals negative s minus 1 squared e to the negative s minus 1 times t dt. Okay, I remember to have dt this time. Dv equals psi t dt. V equals negative cos t. So our limit becomes the limit as w goes to infinity of e to the negative s minus 1 times t psi t minus this e s minus 1 e to the negative s minus 1 t cos t minus integral from 0 to w s minus 1 squared e to the negative s minus 1 times t cos t dt. Okay? So we still have the integral here. But that means that we have to integrate it again. Is that right? No. So if you were about to integrate this, you would get psi. E to the this times psi. And then you still have the integral. Integrate it again, you will get back to cosine. So you just go back and forth between psi and cosine, and it wouldn't let you get rid of the integral. So the way I'm going to solve this is, so you have to solve this. So let's go back to this one. So this is what we started with. And then this is what we ended up with. So let me hide this one. So we have this equals this and equals this. So if you notice, let me use a different color here. We have this, right? And down here, we have this. The only difference is that we have this one, but because we integrate with respect to t, so this is just a constant. So what I'm going to do next is to put this and this on one side, and then keep everything else on the other side, okay? So I'm going to have limit as w goes to infinity. You can see it. The integral from 0 to w, e to the negative s minus 1 t cosine t dt, which is this one. Then move this to the other side. I have positive 0, integral from 0 to infinity, 0 to w, s minus 1 squared e to the negative s minus 1 t cosine t dt equals this. The limits as w goes to infinity. So for this one, you notice we have this and this in common. So I'm going to factor it out. Then what I have left in front of is psi t minus s minus 1 cos t dt. No dt. Okay. Now for this one, I'm going to factor out the integral e to the negative s minus 1 t cos t dt. So I have the limits as w go to infinity, factor out this. What I have left in front of c is 1 plus this, s minus 1 squared times this, okay? And on this side, just rewrite this, okay? So let's rewrite it. Right, so we're almost there. So for this one, because we iterate with respect to t, so the other variable is just constant. So for this one, because this is constant, and the property of, followed by the property of the limit, I can pull this out in the limit. So I'm going to divide both sides by 1 plus x minus 1 squared to get rid of this one. Then I'm going to have the limit as w goes to infinity, the integral of this, which is what we want up here, okay? And on this side, we iterate from 0 to w. So plugging w, I have the limit as w root infinity of e to the negative s minus 1 times w psi w minus s minus 1 cosine w all over 1 plus s minus 1 squared minus, plugging 0, I have 1, so psi of 0 which is 0 minus s minus 1 cosine of 0 is 1 all over 1 plus s minus 1 squared. Now, back to the definition of the Laplace transform. So for the Laplace transform to exist, its values has to converge, which means that it goes to a number. So for this one, it converges. But for this one, it doesn't. So to make this converge, we need to have in the limit of e. So we need to have the exponent goes to negative infinity. Why? Because the limit of e to the negative infinity equals 0. So the limit, the exponent of e goes to negative infinity when s is greater than 1. Okay, so when s is greater than 1 and w goes to infinity, we have e to the negative infinity, and the limit of e to the negative infinity is 0. So it goes to a number, and it converges. Then our final answer is equal to distribute this inside this. So I have s minus 1 over 1 plus s minus 1 squared for all s greater than 1. Alright, so this is your final answer. That's it.
If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.